I'm going to talk in this video about how to support students in developing engaged global learning communities through the use of digital technologies. It's often easy to assume that our students are confident, digitally enabled and engaged citizens, but that's not always the case. However much they may seem at ease on their devices, they may well be out of their comfort zone whilst at university. They may be using technology that's unfamiliar to them, virtual learning environments, Turnitin, and participating in activities that have a different value than their normal online interactions. Part of your digital teaching presence is to support and nurture your students' digital presence and facilitate their engagement. Again, this really goes back to your overall learning design and taking time to plan how, where, and when your students will engage in digital spaces. Your presence is of course important in guiding and keeping students on track, but you need to also help your students develop their own sense of digital agency within the context of the course or programme. Developing engaged global learning communities enables students to be active members of their class, their wider programme, and in turn the university and global communities. So you want to ensure that you're developing active learning approaches for both individual and group activities, which will help to create those global learning communities. You might also want to think about how students can get to know about relevant external learning communities, such as professional societies, key figures in the field, and start to build their professional network too. Asking your professional network to participate in a digital activity can be a great way to do just that. I've personally participated in a number of Twitter scavenger hunts, and I know that the students involved got a real buzz from having interaction with experts outside their university and across the globe. Digital engagement doesn't need to be limited to text either. Getting students to share images of their favourite place to learn, where they live or study, is a great way to let students get a sense of their peers, particularly if you're working with international cohorts. Digital stories, which can combine text, images and video, are another great way to utilise and develop your students' digital and discipline capabilities. You can also make creative use of other digital tools to facilitate synchronous and asynchronous student engagement beyond classroom time. Using approaches such as voting or free text responses can help students to develop their ideas on a topic or to share and answer questions from each other. In terms of their wider digital presence, again, you may want to spend some time getting them to reflect on their own digital capabilities and where they are present online. Getting students to create or just reflect on their digital footprint is a good way to get them to think about who can see what they are sharing. Get them to do a Google search on themselves and reflect on the results. Are they an accurate reflection? Is this what they want people to see? Most employers now do an internet search on potential candidates as part of their selection processes. First impressions count online as well. You can encourage students to develop their digital research and scholarship skills through the activities and communities they engage in. So help them to do just that. Give them pointers and let them explore, create, and share with you and their communities.